Everyone, gather around, gather around. Welcome, everyone. We are here because we are in support of a longtime CUNY organizer, worker here at the Graduate Center named Marisa Holmes. We're here to say that Marisa Holmes should be supported, should be congratulated for her work at CUNY TV. Last week, Marisa found out that she no longer would have her job on Thursday, June 29th. So it's now 6 days since Marisa has been fired illegally from her job. No cause, no warning, no 30 days notice. This is a shock and a blow to us here at the Graduate Center and across CUNY. So we're here because we're saying that Marisa is not alone, that an injury to any one of us is an injury to every single one of us. And that people in District Council 37, people in the Professional Staff Congress, people in all unions and worker centers and neighborhoods around New York City should know that when any one of us is attacked, that we all have their back. So without further ado, let's give a warm welcome for Marisa.
I wanted to talk a little bit today about my history at CUNY. You know, a lot of people know me as an organizer in New York City and different social movements here, but maybe you don't know that, you know, that I'm a CUNY alum, that I went to Hunter College and did an MFA in media there. And the entire time that I was there, you know, from 2011 on, I felt supported by this larger community at CUNY. I felt like I could do the political work that I was doing, that I could make films that were relevant. For my thesis project, I did a feature film on Occupy Wall Street, and they supported me in that, you know, the faculty and students there. When I came to work here at CUNY TV, I wanted to continue that work with Bruno, my good friend and comrade. And we did, I think, really, you know, good work on this show, Canapé. We did a cultural show on French culture, and we had pieces about, you know, Tunisian rappers that were standing up to the regime, the dictatorship in Tunisia, on refugees that were crossing borders and, you know, fighting for their lives, on people here who were struggling in the West African and Haitian communities. And that work, you know, was why I was at CUNY to begin with. So I really felt like I had a political and creative intellectual home here at this institution. But that's what CUNY was about. The CUNY was about, you know, giving people a chance to move up and have protections as workers, giving them a chance to have a public forum. You know, it's a public university and we should use it as a public forum to say whatever we need to say about our conditions and our lives here. This is New York City. CUNY is New York City. We need to remember that. CUNY TV, where I was working, is itself, you know, an educational station. It wouldn't even exist without activism. It wouldn't even exist without the work of people like Dee Dee here, who helped build the community and public and educational access in this country and city. So we need to remember that like these places don't exist without struggle, without our presence here today. So I just wanted to reflect a little bit on my time at CUNY and grounded in that conversation, what it means to be, you know, expelled from this institution and what it means for the future of the CUNY system. Because right now, you know, I'm sure you've all seen in the papers that Cuomo has it out for CUNY. Cuomo wants to take over CUNY and merge SUNY and CUNY and turn this place into a privatized neoliberal environment where none of us have rights anymore, where we don't have the right to organize anymore, where we don't have the right to speak and say what we need to say in a learning environment or on a television station. So, you know, this is the fight that continues here today. This is why we're here, to make sure that not just me, but that any worker, that any member of the CUNY community can stand up and continue to fight. So thank you all for your support.
We next want to hear from the chapter chair of the Graduate Center Professional Staff Congress chapter here at the Graduate Center. Let's welcome Luke Elliott Negri to share some words.
couple years ago, before I was at CUNY, I was fired doing organizing, so I have a lot of empathy for the anxiety, the bizarreness, the uncertainty that comes from that experience. Many folks probably know Marisa through her organizing at Occupy Wall Street, but I met her here organizing in CUNY TV against an insane level of mismanagement, of manipulation of various union contracts. And I first came to a meeting that she organized of probably 25 of her coworkers. So this woman is an organizer, and it seems pretty damn clear to me that she's being fired because that organizing makes CUNY management uncomfortable. So, as the chapter chair here of the Professional Staff Congress Union, I just want to let you know, Marisa, that we've got your back, DC 37, that whatever fight you guys are leading, we're there with you. I'm really looking forward to, hopefully a day or two from now, maybe a week or two from now, this crowd of people walking Marisa back into her job that she should be in.
We're here to win back Marisa's job. Rightfully so, we're also here to make sure that no one should be treated like this at their workplace. That no one should be having the basic job protections that are afforded to them through the struggle that we have done across generations, that shouldn't be taken from us from, you know, the blink of an eye, from the stroke of a pen, from the sending of an email 2 days before someone's told that they have to pack up their stuff. So it means a lot that we're out here today across unions, across different communities in CUNY to say enough is enough. I want to welcome now someone else to share some words, another organizer here in the Graduate Center, Rosa Squillicote.
I'm a member, I'm a CUNY person, I was a CUNY undergraduate. I'm getting my PhD at the Graduate Center right now. I believe in CUNY and I believe in public education, and I think we all do here. And I'm also a member of the PSE, and I'm also a member of the DSA, the Democratic Socialists of America. And for both of those reasons, there is nothing more important than supporting working people in our community, in our building, right? We are CUNY, we are the working class community of New York, we are union people, we are working people, and it is by standing together in solidarity, protecting each other across unions, across titles, across jobs, that we can fight back against Trump's fascism, against Cuomo's bullshit, and that we can actually protect public education in CUNY and what CUNY stands for. And again, rehire Marisa!
The rehiring of Marisa, and to enforce the principle that an injury to one is an injury to all. What this looks like, what it sounds like, and what it smells like is union busting. Ooh. It sounds like, and it looks like, and it stinks like the kind of union busting that arrogant employers and the ruling class are used to doing and used to getting away with. But it's time that they stop getting away with it. People may know that across 34th Street on 9th Avenue is B&H Photo and Video, where over 300 warehouse workers and store workers organized a union in a powerful vote on November 4th of 2015. And now those bosses are trying to bust their union and shut down those warehouses and steal the jobs of over 200 immigrant workers. We need to unite all of those struggles against union busting and for workers' rights. Yeah. And I think that it's important that we link this. By the way, that shutdown of those warehouses is something that Mayor Bill de Blasio was intimately complicit in.
Bravo.
And it's quite a story. But I think that what we need to do is we need to use the power that we have as CUNY employees and as workers throughout this city. And that means, among other things, I think it's very important that there be unity between the PSC, DC 37, the cafeteria workers who are unionized and those who aren't, and all of the other unions at CUNY. And beyond that, I think we should all be in one single university workers union. And I think that we need to establish and enforce our right to strike. And that means using it against the Taylor Law. So that it is not that workers here at CUNY should go in fear of being fired,
but that the employers and the ruling class throughout this city should be in fear when they cross the labor movement and cross the working class. So rehire Marisa now!
Thank you. Rehire Marisa now!
Well, I'm here as an individual who knows Marisa, and that's important, but I'm also here representing Jonathan Smith, the president of the New York Metro Area Postal Union, 5,000 members strong, because we're aware of the fact that CUNY TV, even though they don't know it, is part of the public commons, just as a public postal service is. We're under attack, the workers here are under attack. The most important thing is the need to be able to organize freely, and it's important not just for the unions involved with CUNY to come together as one as the previous speaker was talking about, but it's important for all unions to come together, but all workers, unionized, non-unionized, undocumented, all workers have to come together, because this is our fight for the working class and our rights and protections. And that's why I'm here, and we'll be here next time in bigger numbers from the postal workers, because our union, the American Postal Workers Union, was formed out of a strike, an illegal strike in 1970, and we're now over 200,000 members, and that's what this is about. It's a fight for Marisa, it's a fight for all workers. Rehire Marisa.
We also have a couple more things. There's a petition that's live. There are a couple of people we're specifically calling on to make sure that Marisa gets her job back.